Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm feeling a little hot around the collar. Well, actually, I'm not. But today's demo is all about hot spotting, or as our Teutonic friends like to say, hot spotting. The ability to be able to take your smartphone's connection and use it and share it with your computer or with another device. It's a fairly basic application that's fairly simple to do, and you might wonder why you want to do it, because so many places today have hotspots available to you. You go to almost any coffee shop and you can log on, and there's so many different public hotspots available. Well, there's really two basic reasons that you might want a hotspot. The first reason is convenience. It takes a bit of time to find the network and log on and do all those sorts of things, whereas turning on the hotspot on your phone, incredibly quick. The other reason is security. Now, probably a tiny, tiny percentage of us are ever exposed to any dangers at all when we are using a public network. But let's face it, a public network is less secure inherently than a private network that you're running yourself. So if you're doing things like online banking or any of that sort of stuff when you're out and about, it might be a good idea to do that through your own personal hotspot rather than doing it through a public network. So it's hotspotting today on Dotto Tech. It is a fairly quick and basic demo, which we are going to look at this fine day. We're going to take a look at the ability to take the internet connection that's available on our smartphone, and I have here at the center for your viewing pleasure my Android phone, and on the left-hand side is my iPhone. We go into the same place in both phones to set up hotspots, and it's as simple as can be. In the Android phone, you go into the More Networks area, and there you can find tethering and portable hotspot. So there's basically two ways that you can do this. You can tether your phone using a USB connection, which saves a lot of battery power and allows you to, as a matter of fact, if you say have your notebook computer plugged in, it allows you to be continuously charging your phone while you're doing it. And so that's a great way to set up a hotspot. All you do is you go in and you choose if it's connected by USB or if you want the portable Wi-Fi hotspot. You turn that on, and what will happen is it will turn off. I know it seems counterintuitive, but it actually has to turn off your Wi-Fi in order to turn on the hotspot. But that's because it can't be. It's not bringing in the internet connection at that point there. It's using your mobile radio to connect to the internet. So it's not using the Wi-Fi. On the Mac, it's almost the exact same process. You go into settings, and within settings, right there, you have a personal hotspot button. You can turn on the personal hotspot, which will then allow you to share your hotspot with yourself or with somebody else. You put in a Wi-Fi password there, allow people to log in. The hotspot by default is the name of your smartphone. It's dead simple to do. You can also do the tethering on the Mac, and you can also actually set it up for Bluetooth as well, should you choose to. But for the most part, most people are going to want to set up either a Wi-Fi hotspot or a USB tethered hotspot. It's not something that you have to do all the time. It's nice to know, it's nice and convenient if you do need to use it occasionally. And for the most part, we're gonna choose to use public hotspots that are available because they don't cost us anything. Whereas sometimes, of course, if we're using up our own personal data, that might end up having a cost attached. But the bottom line is, for extra security and extra convenience, nothing beats a portable hotspot. I hope you found today's video to be brief and useful. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first, please subscribe to this YouTube channel. The second thing is sign up for our newsletter, where we send out notification of all of our upcoming webinars, events, as well as our weekly videos. So please sign up for the newsletter. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We're supported by our community through the crowdfunding site Patreon. If you want to know what's involved in being a patron of Dotto Tech, just drop by, or just click on the link for Patreon and take a look. We have all sorts of wonderful perks, including free access to our courses. So check out Patreon if you are so inclined. And that is it for today. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.